My father was the reason I started playing drums and started playing music. He's a keys player, born in East Africa and Tanzania, immigrated to Canada, but we have the Indian roots and come from that origin. At the age of 2, he gave me drums, and we would jam in the basement, him, my twin sister, and I. And he invited me for the first time on stage with him to play a couple of songs on drums, and from then, I became his drummer and just took it from there. I was taking real conservative music in elementary school, but I was doing so much musical stuff outside of school. I was gigging with my dad on weekends sometimes for these community parties that were culturally related. My parents would turn on music that was very Indian classical based, and we'd fall asleep to music every single night. My dad would be having rehearsals on a daily basis, so music was around me 24/7.
Sarah.
Funny thing is, my parents never wanted me to play drums at all. They put me in piano lessons for 10 years, the whole RCM, Royal Conservatory of Music. I did up to grade 8. They put me in singing lessons, Indian classical and Western. They wanted that to be my focus because they were like, drummers never make any money doing any gigs, so you're wasting your time. I'm grateful now that I went through that training, but at that time I was extremely pissed off. Never had a lesson on drums, so I considered myself to be a self-taught drummer, learning from records and so on and so forth. So people ask me, why did you choose the drums? Is it cool? Is it loud? Is it just fun? I said, no, I feel like the drums chose me. I don't feel like I consciously made an effort to play the drums.
Yeah, people think that the drummer plays for the artist. What? Listen, this is not to be confused, okay? Because the artist plays for the drummer. You heard me? You heard me? Let's go. Hey, hey.
My mom told me this. I don't want you to do music because she's an electrical engineer. But if you do it, you have to go all out or don't do it at all. So my motive growing up was just, if I wanna do music, I'm gonna go full out. And out of high school, I just gave it my all. I went to York University. I studied music there. I was the recipient of the Oscar Peterson Scholarship, which basically covered my entire tuition and all my expenses, which was great. So I felt like I was studying in school because I had to keep up my scholarship, but then after hours, practicing 4 hours, going to jam sessions, seeing what I need to do to get to that standard of being a professional musician. If you really want to get into music, don't just think it's all fantastic because of Facebook likes, YouTube views, and touring and just having fun and partying. It's a sacrifice that you don't get to see your family on the weekends. You have to be practicing to upgrade your skill constantly. You have to be very honest with yourself with the sacrifices that you're willing to make and make it very realistic. Because again, people say, yeah, I want to become a famous singer. But what does that even mean in the end? So be very specific with what you want to do. Know the pros and the cons as well. My original music comes from a lot of different influences. I love playing a wide variety of music. I love playing Cuban, Brazilian, obviously Indian when it comes to Bollywood, folk, or classical. North Indian or South Indian. I love playing pop, R&B, hip hop. I play in a gospel church every single Sunday. So I feel all of these influences influence my music. I love calling my music fusion because that's an excuse to say that I use everything in my music. I write the melodies, I write I write the chords as well, but my partner in crime, Jesse Ryan, who's an incredible saxophone player in town, me and him sit down for sessions every single week and we just write and jam out stuff, ideas together. Canada is known for diversity, people-wise and music-wise. We have the luxury of bringing international, very diverse artists from outside. I just feel like we're known for diversity, whereas a lot of places are not. You hear LA musicians maybe have a sound, New York musicians have a sound, New Orleans people have a sound. I feel like we just have a mixture of sounds. I want to live in Toronto, I want to live in Canada. Because of social networking, you don't need to be necessarily in New York to make the contacts or make the links. You can be here and do the same thing.
We felt our opening tonight needed a little extra rhythm, so who better to call upon than Sarah Thawer, who has worked with the likes of Sheila E., Tegan and Sarah. She is a Juno nominee and is inspired by the late Tony Williams. Sarah, are you ready?
I got you, Kyle. Let's do this.
All right. Well, Sarah will lay the beat as I tell you that Matthews is becoming more of a leader for the Leafs this year, while Carey Price has been the most important player for the Canadiens for the better part of a decade. That is the matchup to watch tonight. Sarah, drums, please.